Is Odin stronger than Kaido? This is a question that we all have in our minds from a long time. So I thought I should make a video about it and bring some points from the One Piece manga and the anime to you, which will give us an idea about this heated debate. First of all, before starting with their power comparisons, make sure to leave a like on this video and watch this video till the end to know who is more stronger, Kaido or Odin. So guys, on the one side we have Kaido, the strongest creature in the world. And on the other side we have Odin, who has said to wound the strongest creature. Those are the two some most powerful beings we are looking at. Not just powerful, but also said to be one of the strongest in the whole One Piece world. One is the Yonko of the sea and the other is a samurai equivalent to one. Ever since the first fight between Kaido and Odin, we were left wondering about the true potentials of Odin's powers and capabilities. Okay, so some people might say Kaido won, so Kaido is stronger than Odin. But we know how the Kaido won through that sheer trickery. What if the battle has lasted a bit longer? What if Odin has not failed for the deception? What do you think, who would have won the battle? To be fair, we don't exactly know because Oda doesn't answer my calls. But that won't stop us from trying to measure exactly how much strong and powerful Odin is. This daimyo of Kuri region was the strongest samurai of his time. But the question still remains that asks, how strong was Odin? Odin was able to slash a mountain god in half. He fought and defeated all the Kuri bandits, including their boss Asura Doji. When he decided to scale the seas, he stood against Whitebeard. Even though he did not win, it was still quite amazing that he survived an encounter with the world's strongest human. After few chapters, we also see Odin facing off against Goldie Roger. Again, he managed to withstand the might of Roger, who became the king of the pirates afterwards. These are some of the stories of Kozuki Odin, who fought with the strongest people of the One Piece world. Is it possible that Kozuki Odin was as strong as an admiral? We know admirals are known to be the strongest assets of the marines. An admiral is strong enough to match the strength of a Yonko. And Kozuki Odin was able to wound Kaido, who is a Yonko, but also said to be the strongest creature of the world. Could Odin be at Yonko level as he was able to fight and gravely injure Kaido? We have witnessed the power of Yonkos already, so I don't think I need to explain how powerful Yonkos are. Example for the fight of Marineford, where Whitebeard entered the battle. After that, Shanks appeared and single-handedly stopped the fucking war with his crew. And also Big Mom's Hunger Pants on the other side. And so on and so forth. While we believe Odin was strong, we don't think he was quite as strong as a Yonko. But we do think that he was strong as an admiral. So we could say that Odin was stronger than Kaido in the past, because the Kaido still had a long way to go before being a Yonko level pirate. Okay, so now we have kind of guessed and measured the power level of Kaido and Odin by comparing them with admirals and Yonkos. But the main and the most important question still persists. Could Odin have defeated Kaido? Suppose, if we assume if Kaido vs Odin battle was never interrupted, what the result would have been? Kaido was incredibly strong even then and had a good mastery over his devil fruit. It would have taken a lot more than stab wound to best this beast. And that's the only reason why even though Kaido was injured by Odin, it's not even barely enough to conclude the result of the battle. But in his fight against Odin, Kaido wasn't able to do much against Odin. We have already seen the first fight of Luffy versus Kaido, where Kaido was barely sober and were still taking Luffy's punches without moving from his place. And when he got his consciousness back, we all saw what happened to Luffy. I'm not trying to compare Luffy to Odin, but actually trying to compare Kaido of 20 years ago versus the Kaido of now. So perhaps Kaido had not reached the level of a Yonko at that point in time. True that he was strong, as we have already mentioned, but was he strong enough? I don't think so. So, in short, we think that Odin might have defeated Kaido if the battle has reached its natural conclusions. But let's picture a battle that takes place in the current flow of time. We have Kaido, who has managed to achieve the status of the full-fledged Yonko. For Odin, we think he would have grown a lot stronger in 20 years. What could be the outcome of this match? During the raid of Onigashima, the combined might of 8 Red Scabbards and 1 commander of Whitebeard Pirates was crushed by Kaido. If it wasn't for Luffy and the others, the Scabbards might have never made it out alive. However, one need to remember that these Scabbards have been set 20 years into the future. their powers and skills were the same as 20 years ago. There are even theories roaming around that Kaido was actually born in the Void Century and he knows everything about the Ancient Kingdom, which basically says how many years of experience he must be having in fighting and mastering his devil fruit. Another factor is that Kaido is not even a human. His horns suggest that he might be one of the ancient giant race. Time is sure a factor we all need to consider in this debate. Now, if we go back to the previous section, we established that Odin was stronger than Kaido. And if Odin has managed to grow as much as strong as Kaido without hitting a glass ceiling, then it is highly possible that the monstrous samurai would have succeeded in taking down the strongest creature alive. Again, the lack of any concrete proof or power scaling basis makes it hard for us to conclude. So a stalemate is the best option out there possibly. So do you think was Odin stronger than Kaido? What according to you would be the outcome of a rematch between Kaido and Odin? Let us know what do you think in the comment section down below. And if you enjoyed this video, just don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel because I post daily anime content about top 10 top 5 listings, anime reviews, recommendations, news, theories and all sort of anime content on daily basis. So if you enjoyed, please subscribe, and that was it, and I will see you in the next one. Sayonara.